It's a problem on computation of weighted average cost of capital using book value and market value weights. Let's see. From the following information, determine the appropriate weighted average cost of capital relevant for evaluating long-term investment projects of the company. So, keyword is long-term investment. You are given cost of equity 18.18, that is 18%. After-tax cost of long-term debt is 8%, 0.08. After-tax cost of short-term debt, 0.09. It is irrelevant for us because question wants us to find average cost of capital relevant for long-term investments only. Okay, so short-term funds cannot be or should not be utilized for long-term investment. So this information is irrelevant for us. Then we have cost of reserve, 15%, 0.15. So you are given the source of capital. They are going to use capital 3 lakhs, the book value, and market value of that capital is 7,50,000. Reserves 2 lakh. There is no market value for reserves because the market value of equity, the 7,50,000, it represents 3 lakh, 2 lakh of capital and reserve book value and plus something which is hidden. Okay. Then you have long term debt of 4 lakh, market value is 3,75,000 only. Short term debt, as I said, it is irrelevant for us. Okay, so given these information, we'll get started. Calculation of weighted average cost of capital or overall cost of capital. First, we'll go by book value weights. We are going to go by book value weights only. So what are the elements we have seen? Capital, reserve, long-term debt. You could notice short-term debt is ignored. And these are all the book values which you have seen in the question. 3 lakhs, 2 lakhs, 4 lakhs. So all put together, it is 9 lakhs. Now we have to assign weightages. 3 lakh when compared with 9 lakh. 3 lakh divided by 9 lakh gives you 1/3, that is 33.33%, written as 0.333. 2 lakh out of 9 lakh is 22.222%, so written as 0.222. 4 lakh out of 9 lakh is 44.45%, written as 0.4445. And if you add all this, you should get 1. Okay, fine. So this is the weightage. Then specific cost of capital of each and every source given in the question. For capital, it is 18%. For reserve, it is 15%. For long-term debt, it is 8%. Okay. So we have specific cost of capital. Now, this specific cost of capital should be multiplied with the relevant weight. 18 multiplied by 0.333. 15 multiplied by 0.22. 0.08 multiplied by 0.4445. Let's see. The overall cost of capital we get, when you multiply this, you get 0.06. 15 into this number, 0.03, 0.08 into this number, 0.04. So this is the weighted cost of capital. And if you add all this, 0.06, 0.03, 0.04, you get 0.13. Okay. So the weighted average cost of capital based on book value is 13%. Fine. Next, we'll go and compute based on market value as weights. Okay. So we have the tables. Elements are capital, reserve, long-term debt. Here, as far as the reserve is concerned, we should appreciate that it was shown as market value of equity 7,50,000, and we had only one figure under the question. But now we have to split that between capital and reserve. Let's see how to split. Let me show you. We know the equity and reserves book value. They are 3 lakhs and 2 lakhs. So what was the total? Total works out to 5 lakhs. But this is book value. But what we have now is market value. Market value is 7,50,000. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to equate the 7,50,000 with 5 lakhs. Okay. It means we get to know what is the proportion of equity and reserves. Because out of 5 lakhs, equity is 3 lakhs, which is how much? 60%. And reserves are 2 lakhs, which is nothing but 40%. Okay. So we'll apply the same proportion on this 7,50,000 also. 7,50,000 multiplied by 60% will give you 4,50,000 as equity, and 7,50,000 multiplied by 40% will give you 3 lakh. Okay. So we are going to say market value of equity and reserves are 4,50,000 and 3 lakhs. Let's see. Here you have market value of capital 4,50,000, market value of reserves are 3 lakhs, and long-term debt given in the question is 3,75,000, which is different from the book value, because book value is a different figure, right? Now if you add all the three, you are going to get 11,25,000. Now you have to arrive at the weight, that is 4,50,000 when expressed as a proportion of 11,25, it is only 40%. 3 lakh expressed as proportion of 11,25 is 27%. 3,75,000 expressed as proportion is 33%. So everything written in decimals overall is 1. And we are also given the specific cost of capital in the question. 18% for capital, 15% for reserves. See, it is only because of this distinction we were forced to divide this also. Otherwise, we could have simply gone with 7,50,000 comprising capital and reserve, and we could have simply multiplied with the specific cost of capital as 18%. But in this question, you have a distinction between the cost of capital and cost of reserves. So that is the reason we went for splitting. Okay. Then the cost of long-term debt, after-tax cost of long-term debt is 0.08. Now you have to multiply these respective cost with this weight. So you get 0.18 into 0.40 is 0.0720, 0.15 into 0.27 is 0.0405, 0.08 into 0.33 is 0.0264. So you get 0.1389, and so you get weighted average cost of capital as 13.89%.